Hey people, Paul Mucker here. Today is June 18th, 2011 at 11:33 p.m. If you look how quickly the moon have turned into a, what you call it, gobius, whatever you call it. But I call it three quarters, okay? Look how quickly, people, look how quickly. People, okay, it's getting shorter and shorter and shorter because remember, right, the moon every 28 days, we supposed to have a full moon every 28 days, right? Right? Okay. And May 20, no, around May 17th, May 18th, we had a super full moon, right? And May 18th, we had a super full moon. Today is May 18th. And look at the moon is. The moon has already passed super full and is already a three quarter. People, this is a phenomenon, okay? Don't let NASA fool you all. Don't let no one tell you all this is natural. Because there's nothing natural about this. Every 28 days, at least, we have a full moon. We had a super full moon in less than 28 days. And the first super moon we had was March 19th, 2011. We had one March 19th, 2011. April 17th, May 18th, somewhere around there, and now we had June 13th. So you see, so it went 5 days back, June 13th, and now today is June 18th, and the moon is on its way. It's past being a super full moon. Look at that, people. This is a phenomenon, okay? There's really a drastic change in our world. And how is that we keep having super full moons and not regular new moons? Well, when was the last time y'all seen a new moon, people? We're getting pure super moons, super full moons, not new moons. My Lord say he's tired of your new moons and your Sabbaths and your feasts and your festivals. He says he's tired of bearing them. Okay? He says he's tired of bearing your full moons and bearing your new moons and your illusions. So people, see for yourself, there's a change. Less than 28 days, we're getting super moons, less than 28 days. So that means if the sun catch up with the moon, just like the sun caught up with Jupiter and Venus. See, Jupiter and Venus, right, are now outshined by the sun because they're both morning stars and outshined by the sun. If this sun catch up with the moon, because the moon obviously is going slower, faster, right? So if the moon is moving faster, right? That means it's catching up to the speed of the sun. So that means the moon and the sun will be showing together very clearly. Or the sun will be shining in the night. The sun will be shining in the night. So people, don't be surprised, okay? If you have a day where the sun doesn't go down at all. I'm serious. Or did a total eclipse. Okay, one of the two people, okay? We either gonna have a super eclipse, or we're gonna have the sun gonna stay up for a whole day. Or it's gonna stand still at midday and don't go down for a while, okay? Mark my words. Either a super eclipse, or the sun gonna stand still. Because the moon is catching up to the sun, people. And if you have a super full moon, excuse me, if you have a super full moon and an eclipse, wow people. If you have a super full moon and an eclipse, do you know the catastrophe that could cause? Because the moon, the evil men are trying to get the moon to black out the sun, to blind the sun. Okay? That's like Set. Okay? It's like they're pitting the sun against the moon. And that's evil spirits are doing that, okay? Pitting the sun against the moon. So if the sun and the moon eclipse, that means the eye of Ra is blinded. Ra is blinded. Both his eyes are blinded. Both his eyes are blinded. Because remember, the sun is the right eye of Ra and the moon is his left eye. According to the legend. So if the sun stands in front of the moon and the moon stands in front of the sun, that means he's blinded. Because both his eyes, he's like cross-eyed. And that's when the evil men are going to take advantage. Okay, that's when the evil men are going to take advantage of us and rain down the destruction on us. But don't worry, my people. Our spirits are stronger than theirs, okay? So, but I believe they're going to be an eclipse, though, honestly. It may be in July, who knows? Don't quote me on that, okay? I'm just my sense is telling me that, you know? Misty morning, I don't see no sun. I know you're out there somewhere having fun. There is one mystery I just can't express. To give you more, to receive your less. One of my good friends say, in a reggae with them, don't jump in the water if you can't swim. Yeah, it's gonna be a misty morning. You won't see the sun. Okay, it's gonna be a total eclipse. Anyway, that's all for now, folks. Actually, let's see if anything gonna fly across the moon.